So I've been on my like grind, okay. So my current work schedule has me going into work at 12 p.m. And I've been going to the gym for about like a month. And I've been going at 7 a.m. for like, this is my second week going at 7 a.m. And let me tell you, if I stay. question is, what kind of music do you like? And honestly, that is such like a hard-ass question for me to answer, because I'm like, oh wait, listen, oh, what kind of music do you like? I like a lot of different genres of music. Now if you ask me to name all the genres on the top of my head, I will forget every single one. Is like it's very damaging to one's like like self-confidence, because not everything you see online is real, but like you don't really think about that, you just look at it and you're like, whoa, you know what I mean? But then at the same time, I feel like I've learned a lot Me too. Adulthood scares me. So I got the e.l.f. Halo Glow setting powder, and I believe I got it in the color light because they didn't have a translucent shade. I'm gonna tell myself not to be so scared to like go out of my comfort. Personally, I was blessed to have my parents take care of me financially until I was like 20. No, 19, I think it was like 19 or 20. Because I didn't get my job until then. And up until that point, they would buy me everything. Because obviously I had no money. So I'm very thankful. But like, you know, obviously when you get to a certain age, it's like, alright now, like, you gon' ask your parents for money forever, you know? So, but and also they pressured me to get a job or look for a job, but you know, I just feel like parents are always gonna, or maybe not always, but some parents are just gonna, you know, remind you of it every second they can have to remind you about the fact that they pay for everything. Making responsible decisions, and not just like in that moment that are like responsible, but like future that will be like considered responsible in the future that would have no negative impacts on your future. You get what I mean? Like, don't be so easily influenced, because especially getting to like that adult age, a lot of people around you don't have that same thought process of thinking like, oh my god, I'm getting older, let me not make idiotic decisions, you know. I'm just sitting better, and my freckles, they're freaking huge today because I didn't want to use the pen. So yeah, in all honesty, you got it, like, trust me, you got this. It is definitely very scary, but you can do it. You'll be great. What would I bring to a deserted island? Weed. Well, if it has to be like survival mode, I think I would take, it doesn't have to be like realistic, or can it literally be like, I guess it like, I don't know. I think I'd rather just off myself than go than be at a deserted island. Okay guys, I'm back. I don't know if it's because I haven't done my makeup in a long time, but I struggled so hard to put these lashes on. It's not even funny. So then the next one is, if you could ask anyone dead or alive one question, who would it be and what would you ask? Honestly, I'm not gonna say no. Heartfelt, meaningful. But then, what's your guilty pleasure? My guilty pleasure? I have a lot of guilty pleasures, if I'm gonna be honest. I have a lot. One of my guilty pleasures is rewatching Grey's Anatomy and H2O. I'm currently rewatching Breaking Bad right now. What else? I like to watch, even though I fucking hate cigarettes, I love watching younger. I love watching videos that give me nostalgia. Okay, so.